July 5th, Sunday, and it's 60, almost 2 degrees out, and I'm going to go check on the boxes today.
So today, I loaded everything up because I don't know what I'm going to see when I go in there. True. That's my boy.
You good? Pretty nice day out. You guys had a tough night. So today the bees are pretty busy. And the big hive is always busy. Blackberry nectar flow is on. This little hive over here I hope has the queen in it. Find out. At least they're going in and out. I hope it's not just rubbing, but they seem to be going in and out all the time. I have not seen any pollen coming into that one, so I really don't know what's in there. Could be absolutely nothing left and they're just rubbing it out, but we're gonna find out.
And these,
not very many. We've got some nectar coming in. That's good. See some queen cups. They're definitely a little colony, but they also don't have anybody for a queen. Alright, now we come to the big hive. They really want a queen from. I hope has righted themselves, but I don't know yet. And they're drying that one out. And they're actually drying out to here, so that's good. Okay, this is the one that has questionable cells on there. And there is a queen excluder on here, I think. Yeah, there's a queen excluder on this one. So they should not have eggs up in here, but from what I understand, they can move them. Worker bees can take the eggs and pick them up and move them around if they choose. So there's this, and there's this, and I just scooted my knife right through that, unfortunately. And those are all empty green cups. I'm done capped. So that's another one that's going well. This is heavy. More nectar, not catching up with where they're bringing it in. That's good. Nectar being put in there. More nectar. Plenty of room. Sure. Wow, I think there's a bunch of honey. Holy cow, that one looks big. If I find my queen, that would be fabulous, but right now I'm seeing holy cow. Nectar. Lots of nectar. And I don't want to start over again next year. So, let's see what we can do here. Mm-hmm. I see a queen. One last box to go through. Okay, very last rope here. I'd like to have a queen. See any eggs in her yet, which makes me really sad. All of her brood is hatched out and they are filling it with honey, but I have yet to see an egg or any brood. Gonna get lots of honey. Claire will be happy. We'll be happy, we'll have some honey. But anyway, no eggs, not even a. Which means I'm going to have to take a queen cell from that hive, which doesn't thrill me. You know, it's really sad. I buy a tractor and a lawnmower, and I have to wait in line for them.
You want to get another one?
I might have to have a his and hers. And get her in the house, because she already got stung.
Really?
Yes. Jerk. She did. She thinks this is playtime, and then she gets stung, and I'm giving her Benadryl, you know. He bred some drones. I'm really disappointed. The queen is no more. Not even a legacy. Nothing that looks even remotely close to doing anything. Anything at all. I think I should put these off. So, my least favorite hive is going to be my resource hive now. I have to get for a little green hive. They need a frame of eggs, and the big hive needs a frame of eggs because they're both queenless, and I don't want them to start having a drone layer situation. So here we go into my other one. One queen cell with royal jelly in it and a lot of caprere.
just coming out, several of them. One of them just hatched. It's very fuzzy. They're fuzzy little things when they're brand new. So I'm going to give this frame, I think, to the little bitty hive over here. They're chewing its way out. This one's coming out. That one's coming out. Hopefully you can see it. There she goes. New baby.
I'm giving this weaker hive this bunch brood that is hatching right now. It has maybe a couple eggs in it. I hope that they can make a queen.
These guys need space for the queen to lay.
There's a queen cup that has royal jelly in it. Might be two coming. I don't need this queen to. There. Queens have royal jelly in it. There is larvae in that. So, I think I'm also giving it to the big hive.
How's it going?
It's interesting.
You got every box torn apart.
Yes, I did, because I had two queenless hives.
So what's your game plan here since you got them all torn apart?
Well, here's the thing. I put brood into that little green box that had eggs in it so they can make a queen. I put brood that's hatching in there too so that they'll hatch fast and be a boost to their numbers. And then I put a frame of this hive brood with eggs in that one on the right that also have a queen cell started with a larvae in it. And it's probably 4 days old. So I'm gonna call it July 1st, it started a queen cell, which means it should hatch on the 16th, which means then it will mate somewhere by the 20th. And by the end of the month, I should have it laying eggs in that hive.
So that hive is sitting how?
This
one? What
does
it need or where is it at?
This one is the only one with a good queen.
Oh really? So that one's okay.
This one is okay, but it's also the one I like the least because the queen is the mean, you know, they had the meaner genes. I thought one hive might have made a queen and it didn't. I thought if I were super lucky, two of them might, but one just decided to make its own little branch colony. And one that I stole brood and a queen cup and eggs from to give to the really big one that's queenless. And the medium-sized one that is queenless. And I gave that one emerging brood as well, so it should double its numbers pretty quick. And I gave drawn comb to the other one where the queen kind of ran out of room. The one I stole everything from kind of ran out of room for laying, so I gave her some drawn comb from the old hive. And that little one on the table still has a little cluster of bees in it, so I'm going to wait a little bit and see if I get another queen cell I can put in there, but it's getting late, so that's my July 5th queen report.